and welcome to this painting video. In this video, we'll be showing you how to paint the armour and smouldering effects of House Khomentis. Now, before we begin, we need to give our war dog here an undercoat of Mephiston Red, and now we can start with the red armour. For this, we'll be applying a shade of cardboard crimson all over the red plating. Now, we're going to start by dipping our brush in. Make sure that I haven't got too much on my brush, but we are going to be applying it straight to the model. And now we're going to just pop it onto all the plating towards the top of the model. If you find it kind of goes into the recesses too much, don't worry, clean off your brush and just remove it with the tip of the brush. Now with the shade dry, we're going to move on to a tidy up stage of Mephiston Red, then we're going to apply a highlight of Evil Sun Scarlet. So we're just going to get out the Mephiston Red out of the pot, then we're going to thin it down a little bit of water, we don't want it too thick, and then we can start applying it to some of the raised areas, or anywhere that might have too much shade, so then it doesn't look too dark or too streaky. Now with our Mephiston Red now dry, we can move on to our Evil Sun Scarlet just to do the edging of the panels. Now don't worry if you do make it a little bit too thick or make a mistake, you can always tidy up with some Mephiston Red afterwards. Now with the red armour finished, we're going to move on to the gold trim. For this we'll be using a base coat of Retributor armour, then applying Nazdrake Yellow to the recesses, then finishing off with some highlights of Skullcrusher Brass and Stormhost Silver. So let's go on with that Retributor armour. So we're just going to take it out of the lid of the pot, and we're just going to thin it down slightly with a touch of water, just so we get a little bit smoother onto our brush, and then we can start applying it to our metalwork. So make sure that it's nice and smooth. If you think it's a little bit too thin, don't worry, you can apply another layer. But we just want to make sure that it's not too lumpy in some areas. Now that the Retributor armour is now dry, we can apply our Nazdrake Yellow into the recesses of the metal. If you find it's a little bit too thick, you may want to thin it down or just try and move it around with a clean brush. And now that our Nazdrake Yellow is now dry, we're going to move on to our first highlight of Skullcrusher Brass. So we're just going to make sure that this one's a little bit thicker, just so we get some good definition for our next highlight. Now that our Skullcrusher Brass is now dry, we can finish off with a nice thin highlight of Stormhost Silver. Yeah, we're going to go over the same areas as before, just going to make sure it's a little bit thinner. Now that the gold trim is finished, we can move on to the smouldering effect found on some of the panels of House Khomentis. For this, we'll be using Corvus Black for the base coat, then using Eschen Grey for an ashy effect. So we're just going to get out some Corvus Black, get it onto our palette. That's a good consistency. I'm going to just add a touch of water, just so my brush has a nice point. We can start applying it to our armour. So I'm going to apply it to the back end of the armour. So I'm going to put it onto the back half of these plates, and you can add it to the rest of the leg plates afterwards. Now that our Corvus Black is now dry, we're going to add some Eschen Grey to create some charring effect ready for our next stages. So we're just going to put them randomly in places to look like they started to burn through the armour. Now that our Eschen Grey is now dry, we can move on to the Burning Embers. For this we'll be using a base of Scrag Brown, then some mid-tones of Troll Slayer Orange, and then some spot highlights of Flash Gets Yellow. So let's get that some of that Scrag Brown out the top of the pot, and put it on our palette. I'm going to thin it down quite a bit. We don't want it to be too thin nor too thick, so it flows nicely on our brush. Now we're going to start applying it on top of that Eschen Grey. So we want to make sure that it's nice thinnish lines, but we want to give it a little bit of shape. You can use the tip of the brush if you want, just to kind of stipple it along, but some nice thin strokes as well won't hurt. And we can start building it up. Now that our scrag brown is now dry, we're going to add some Troll Slayer orange just to add some mid-tones to those lines. So we're going to just add little areas. We're not going to fill the whole line in. We're just going to start building up some bright colours. Now that our Troll Slayer orange is finished, you can see that I've done some connective lines, and now we can add some spot highlights of Flash Kits Yellow to finish our effect off. And with that Flash Kits Yellow now dry, our House Khomentis armour is now complete. And by following this guide, you can apply any of these methods and techniques to the rest of your collections. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye!